This week we have hot patching, VM deletion magic, some Spring Cloud, and cross-region restores. I'm Lars Klint, and you are watching Azure This Week, a show with more hosts than you can poke a stick at. Oh, what's that down there? It's a subscribe button. Try clicking it. The best part of IaaS is rebooting your Windows servers after installing a path or update. Said no one ever. You know what I mean. Rebooting any computing device is a bit annoying, but when it comes to servers that run your critical business processes, it can get downright hairy. The wait for everything to come back up, the anxiety of critical patches, the late night scheduling of downtime, and so much more. Now, there is hot patching though. Yeah, you can patch and update Windows Server Azure Edition Core virtual machines on Azure without requiring a reboot. I know! It works by patching code in memory of the running processes. You will need the hot patches from Microsoft, and so far it only works on Windows Server 2022 Data Center Azure Edition, but it is a start. This should improve the protection, deployment times, and availability for all your Server 2022 VMs. Combining this with Azure Auto Manage and Azure Orchestrated Patching, managing VMs is now even easier. One thing to note is that when you still... As well as other installer, you're like... One thing to note is that when you... Sorry. One thing to note is that you will still need to reboot VMs when you're installing updates that aren't hot patched, as well as after installing what Microsoft calls baseline updates, happening roughly once a quarter. Get all the details and how to set up hot patching using the link in the description. I don't know if you want to put a little label or something, tip of the week, I don't know. Or minor update of the week, I don't know, something, you figure it out. This week's small but hugely helpful improvement. You can now automatically delete disks, NICs, and public IPs associated with a VM when you delete that VM. Only took us a decade, but well, it's finally here. Yay! To be honest, this story is not my strong side. I haven't used the Spring Cloud with VMware on Azure, but if you have, you might also have got the benefits, and that is, well, letting you focus on apps instead of security patching, scaling, and monitoring. In fact, Spring Cloud has been so popular that Azure has created a new enterprise tier. At least that's what they claim. I'm sure it has nothing with being able to charge more. Anyway, the new enterprise tier includes commercially supported Spring runtime components to help enterprise customers ship faster and unlock Spring's full potential, as Microsoft Marketing puts it. This is the next step in the collaboration between Microsoft and VMware. The plan is to eventually let you deploy polyglot applications that are inherently portable across any Azure service, any cloud, and any on-premises system. Big claim, I like it. If you're a fan of Spring Cloud on Azure, the new enterprise tier is now in preview, so go try it out. Is 2022 the year of picking up cloud computing knowledge? Then check out ACG's free plan. It gives you access to free courses and quizzes, plus learning paths and original series content. Currently, for the month of February, the full course Introduction to the Microsoft Cloud Adoption Framework for Azure is free, as well as a bunch of other content. And you don't need a credit card to sign up. I'll include links in the description below. You can now create VM restore points in any public region of your choice, irrespective of which region the VM is deployed to. Let's say you have a workload running on a VM in East US, which you want to protect from disasters. Now, while this is uncommon, it could potentially bring down the entire region. Oh! You can now periodically create VM restore points in a target region far, far away from your source region, like North Europe. If your workloads deployed in East US becomes inaccessible due to any kind of disasters or failures, you can use one of the restores points, you know, created in North Europe to create a failover VM with minimal data loss and downtime. Neat! But that isn't all. You can also copy restore points between regions for added flexibility. So much VM goodness this week. I love that hot patching feature. Well, what do you think? Let me know. If you want more cloud in your brain, check out the ACG platform and consider signing up for a free account too. we'd love to have you join our friendly learner community. Next week, we have another new face on the show. So take good care of Ace. He is, well, an ace. I'll see you in the cloud. Keep being awesome cloud gurus. And backwards one.